Hi, my name is Stephanie Winslow, and I'm a stroke coordinator.
And my name is Rachel Paciorek. I'm a stroke coordinator. We are at Baystate Medical Center in Springfield, Massachusetts.
And today we'll be speaking about our process for dysphagia screening of our stroke patients.
We have no disclosures.
And the objectives for today are being able to identify the AHA guidelines for dysphagia, describe the dysphagia screening process, and describe the process for implementation and staff education.
This slide is the AHA and the ASA guidelines for early management of acute ischemic stroke. The dysphagia screening before any oral intake is a Class 1 strong recommendation. In this presentation, we'll be reviewing our process for dysphagia screening before oral intake.
So, why are we concerned about dysphagia in our stroke population? Well, as you can see from the slide, there are many risk factors and complications from swallowing impairments, such as aspiration pneumonia. Dysphagia is a common complication of stroke and associated with high mortality and worse outcomes. Early screening for dysphagia can help identify these patients that are at a higher risk for aspiration.
There are many variations of swallowing screening tools. Some examples are listed here. However, there is no universal or recommended tool by the Joint Commission.
Our process for screening started around 2009. And as you know, stroke patients have many varying deficits. And to help capture those patients for screening, we broaden our screening population to include any patient presenting with neurological symptoms. Our first line of screening is done by either our emergency department nurses or our inpatient neuro unit nurses. Screening can be done by our neuro providers who can document that it was completed. The screening is nurse-driven and can be done without an order. However, we do have it included in our stroke order sets. There is also a task that fires for the dysphagia screen whenever a patient is admitted to our stroke unit. It is the expectation of the nurse to contact the provider to place a formal consult for swallow evaluation on any patient who fails a bedside swallow screen. With our intubated patients, we stress the importance to have the correct route ordered for which the medications will be administered.
Here are the neurological deficits that we include when we educate staff that a swallow screen should be considered. Inability to speak, decreased sensation, memory loss, difficulty with thought process, altered mental status or confusion, impulsive behavior or poor judgment, vision changes, loss of balance or coordination, dizziness, severe headache, and weakness of face, arms, or legs.
This is our dysphagia screening form our nurses use when performing a bedside swallow screen. This was created using the four elements of the nurse dysphagia screening tool, and the majority of our patients who pass do not have any disabling deficits. This form is easy to access in our electronic medical record and quick to perform. Nurses can repeat a screen when a patient has a change in condition. For example, if a patient originally failed the swallow screen but now seem to be improving, they can rescreen the patient to see if they would pass. This is the same for a patient who may have passed but condition worsened. We have in our stroke policy that stroke patients are NPO, no exceptions, until a bedside swallow is completed or a formal swallow eval is done. Since early antithrombotics are important, we included in our stroke order sets to have PR aspirin until patient passes the dysphagia screening. Stroke coordinators provide more extensive stroke education to the ED, neuro unit, rapid response team, and ICU. In most cases, our stroke patients are admitted to our dedicated stroke units.
Implementation of the dysphagia screening form took the help of the stroke nurse champions and nurse educators in the emergency department, neuro units, ICU, and our rapid response team. In order to get buy-in from key stakeholders, we shared our performance measures that were lacking compared to other facilities. These performance measures were shared with our leadership and our stroke model of care team. An acute stroke packet was also created for nurses to use when an acute stroke patient arrived to our facility. This packet included a checklist with the swallow screen as one of the tasks to be performed. To improve compliance, we have a program at our facility where if you would like to recognize someone, you can fill out a recognition form that is sent to the employee and their manager. These forms have point values you can exchange for gifts. They can be included in annual performance reviews, or nurses may use them in their portfolios.
One area we noticed many fallouts were our intubated patients. Medications were being ordered and documented by mouth, but they were actually given OG or NG tubes because the patients were intubated. We worked with the ICU educators who created an alert inside of our electronic medical record that reminds nursing to ensure the medications are ordered for the correct route which it will be given. Another area for improvement was the time of the dysphagia screening was documented after PO medications were given. Nurses were performing the swallow screen and then administering the medication, but just documenting it backwards. Education and reinforcing have become a part of our process for improving documentation accuracy.
So as you can see, education is huge. As you can see, we are very involved working collaboratively with multiple departments and providing education to staff frequently. We educate on the why and not just on the task. This really helps with compliance because then staff have a better understanding of the significance of the dysphagia screen.
One of the ways we reinforce education is sending out these opportunity for improvement emails. During our daily chart audits of stroke patients, if we find there is something that was missed or not documented correctly for the dysphagia screen, we'll send out these emails to outline what the error was. And in these emails, we include the staff member as well as the educators.
We reinforce education by doing the following. We have annual online stroke education modules that include the dysphagia screening. We give education to all nursing units to spread awareness. We do physician education. We report out to leadership, and then stroke coordinators respond to strokes and emphasize swallow screening with not only the nurses, but the physician as well.
Some of our common challenges. So staff turnover, we're continuously educating to various units for new hires. Which patients are getting screened? Anyone with a neurological symptom. This helps us capture those patients who may have localized deficit, but an MRI day later shows a positive infarct. Symptoms resolved. We still expect staff to do a swallow screen in these cases to ensure patients are safe to swallow. And neurological symptoms outside of the acute window, we still expect screening again to ensure that these patients are safe to swallow. In closing, education and feedback are the biggest proponents to helping us achieve success with our dysphagia screening, as well as keeping our stroke patients safe.
And here are some references that we used to create this presentation. Thank you.
Thank you.